Greetings. There once was a great storyteller. He could tell stories that could entertain and enthrall. But his greatest stories came when he bragged about himself. In his stories, he could do anything. In his stories, he took magic carpet rides. In his stories, he knew the history of the world. In his stories, he was a great warrior. In his stories, he could satisfy a dozen wives. And while he could do anything in his stories, in real life, he was frustrated by one very serious shortcoming. No, not that. Get your mind out of the gutter. Now, where was I? In real life, he was frustrated by one very serious shortcoming. The greatest storyteller in the world could not read nor write. But many people loved his stories. They would follow him to learn his stories. They would memorize his stories and repeat them to others. But they would also sometimes change his stories. The people did not memorize so good, so perfectly. And so the friends of the man, those who called themselves his companions, they found some educated men who could read and write. These men were called scribes. And they were compelled to write the stories of the great storyteller. With so many followers and such powerful companions, the storyteller became filled with pride. He even claimed his stories were from a divine source. To embellish his claim, he said that the God of his fathers had written the stories, and all who followed his stories were in fact following a message from the God of his fathers. Among the scribes, there was one very bright and clever man. When the storyteller was reciting a tale, sometimes he would pause, searching for the right word. And the smartest of the scribes, hearing the best rhyme in his own mind, would offer his suggestion to complete the phrase. "Excellent," he would say. "That is exactly the word I was searching for." And he would command the scribe to write it down just as the scribe had suggested. But over time, the scribe began to ponder on a serious question. The scribe knew that the storyteller claimed his God gave him the stories. And the scribe knew that he, the scribe, had also changed the stories. And he was troubled. The scribe knew he was not a prophet like the storyteller claimed to be. And the scribe also knew that some of the words the storyteller claimed came from his God were truly suggestions of the scribe, fixing the stories for the storyteller. And still the scribe would smile and receive his income from the companions of the storyteller, for they had begun to profit from the sales and other forms of attention given to the storyteller. And they told the scribe to never speak of his contribution to the stories from God. But still it troubled the heart of the scribe. How could he, a scribe, add words to the message of a God? If the stories came from a God, why did the storyteller need help completing parts? He had no answer, but he began to doubt the storyteller. He continued to make suggestions, and the storyteller continued to include them. And after several years of this and many examples, the scribe knew he was not safe in the employ of the companions. The scribe knew the messages from a God came from himself. And he knew that he was no God, no prophet of a God. So when he found a chance, he ran away. Many years passed and the storyteller became more famous. So famous he was rich enough to buy the town he grew up in. And he did buy the town so that he could return. For once upon a time his stories had offended the people of his town, and they had driven him out of town hoping he would never return. But now he returned leading many followers. But the storyteller wanted some peace in his old hometown, so he sent gifts to most who had offended him. But there were a few he would not forgive. He sent men to kill those who he would not forgive, and his old scribe was one who could not be forgiven. So the old scribe, the one who wrote for a god, was killed by a man who could neither read nor write. The years passed and the storyteller grew old, and while many scribes came and went, none helped as much as the scribe he killed. But in the end, the storyteller was killed by one of his wives. She knew the stories were not true and were not from a god. She knew the storyteller and how the stories were made up for his own benefit. And in the end, she ended his life by poisoning him, because he had once said, "If my stories are not from the god, may I be poisoned." And his words were written down by a scribe. The pen is mightier than the sword, but none are more mighty than he who holds the book of life. Would it make any difference to know this story is based on two real men? Was the scribe justified to fear the storyteller? Was the storyteller actually receiving his stories from God? If so, why would he let the scribe change the stories from God? May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.